All right, so let's go ahead and end the meeting and then get into how we set up the information for the recording for other people to view it after we close the recording. Again, you have a couple different options. You can click on the meeting tab and you can hit the record meeting right there and it'll stop, or you can hit the red button right here and you can say stop recording. No more red button, so we're not recording anymore. People are still in the meeting though. Okay, that's just, we just stopped the recording. So just keep in mind that people, if you still have participants in here, they're going to be in the meeting until you end meeting. So you click on end meeting. You can add a little message here saying, hey, thanks for joining. Please join us next time. Same bat time, same bat channel type of thing if you'd like. And you have right here, open this URL for everyone if you'd like to. You can open up a URL. Don't worry about that too much because we're going to go into further detail later on. So hit OK. And this will pop up. If you want to get back in real quick, you can by hitting Start Meeting. If not, you can just go ahead and exit out. And then you can go down to your bar and find these other the other windows that had popped up that I told you to minimize earlier. There they are. All right. This guy you do not need. You can go ahead and close that out because that dealt with the meeting. All right. And so we're back into this one. Again, if you're still logged in, you can go ahead and hit the home button, let it refresh, okay, because you've been out of it for a while. Then what you need to do is you can go to meetings up here. Not create new because we've already done it, but we need to go to our meetings. Once you go into the meetings, you will see the other classes. What I did here was I've already set up a few. Say you have Connect 101, Connect 205, Connect 800. But we are in our Connect 205. So if you select Connect 205, here is where you see if you need to edit that information, you can. Again, you can change the name, you can give a different summary if you'd like. Anyone who has the URL can enter the room if you want to change that access. But you cannot change the URL, just keep in mind. But go ahead and go back to the meeting information. Here is where you, well, let me back up. So you say you're going in for your next recording session, okay, for your next maybe live meeting. Go back to 205, go to Enter Room. Do not set up a new one. Okay, always stay within that course name and go back into that meeting. So you'd hit enter meeting and it would pop up and give you this. It would say it has ended the meeting, but since you're the host, you can always start the meeting. Okay, keep that in mind. But we do not want to do that right now. We're not going to record it. We're going to end the meeting again. Hit OK. That's going to pop up and we can close that out. We can close that one out. Okay, so we're back here. Again, what I would do now is go to recordings. Okay, this is where you need to go to find the previous one that we had just done. If you hit recordings, that's where Connect 205 week one is. And so if we would have recorded that one we just went into, you know, you can name it week two or give it a name of a different, you know, name of the lecture and so forth. Okay, that's where you would have multiple weeks. Okay, and that's how you record them. Here's the thing. Right now, they cannot view them. If they have this URL right here, this is the unique one for that specific recording, they would not be able to play it because we have not made it public. You see right here, it's still set as private. What happens is, what we need to do is make it public, which all we need to do is go to select the box, make public. And you'll see that changed. And now the recordings are accessible to all. If we want to make it public again or private, click on there. It says here the private setting if you hover over are accessible to the edit participants list. And that's where you go, edit participants. Notice that only me and our facilitator people are allowed to actually view it. So nobody else would have it. All right. You can edit the information here if you wanted to rename it. Again, sorry, that's for the actual meeting. Okay, see how I kind of got lost right there? What a perfect example. I just go home, all right, and I'm going to start over again. So I go to meetings, 205, and then I go to recordings, I want to make it public. So I go ahead and select that box, make public. All right. And once I click on it, okay, this is the link that for an on-demand lecture, or say someone missed that live meeting and they want to go back to it, you're like, okay, let me send you that link. Here's the link that you would use. Okay, copy paste it in an email. This is the link that if you want to show them that meeting or that lecture with an e-college and actually have it, I guess, embedded into e-college, this is how you would do so. And I'll show you that here also coming up. Okay, so this is where then you would actually enter the recorded meeting that you saw. You can go in there, click on it, and then it'll populate. Give it a minute to upload for you, and when it does, there you go. You can see that this is the host. At that time when we were starting the meeting, we weren't sharing anything. We can move into there. We can advance it. You see how I'm messing around with the chat button right now, chat pod, and earlier you saw the notepad. Okay, so I'm moving things around there. So that's where you can view the recording. Again, for on demand, or if someone missed it, they can go back to it. You can put this into eCollege. You can email out the link and so forth. Just close that out. Say you needed to edit the recording. All right. So if you edited the recording, all you would have to do is hit edit recording. You go there, it'll open up the meeting, and it'll give you a few extra little features. It's a very simplistic editing. It's in-point, out-point type of editing. And down here is, here's your cursor for your time. You move it back and forth, and you see right over here your webcam, your time actually moving.
Participants all right. To see you. And, for
and these little triangle buttons, okay? This is where, say we don't want, let me go ahead and pause. Say we don't want to start until a minute into it, okay? So you go to the minute. Well, this is your beginning point, your end point. And here's your out point. See how I'm dragging it? It's kind of making a different color, a little shaded blue. You can see your time is moving. So let's go ahead and go to a minute. All right. So you have that highlighted, and you've set your in and out points. Well, then you are able to cut. All right. And then once you've cut, you can move those and see how that blue still stays there. That's going to be a cut spot. So say we don't want the last minute, 2 seconds. So that would mean we need to go to 35. Good enough. And we need to set that now. See how I drag that? Now that is going to be cut if I hit cut right now. So I need to readjust my endpoint. And so my endpoint is going to be right at that marker on the cursor, which is about 3502. 35 will work. And so there we go. So we're going to cut off that. So what you do is, since you set it, you hit the cut button, and then you can adjust. See how, again, now we have endpoints, outpoints. You can do it in the middle as well. Say we don't want this part right there. Go ahead and cut that. All right. Notice that we have not hit the save button yet, and you can also do an undo if you need to. And then here's the save button that I just mentioned. But notice how we have 36 minutes and 2 seconds. If you hit the save button, it's going to save those changes. And give it a second to make those changes. Okay. And should be less than 36 minutes and 2 seconds. Yep, our total time now is 3201, okay? And we've made the edits. Now, say you're done. Say you see down here, though, you have revert to original. You can do so from right there, or keep in mind, we're in the edited version, so that's 32 minutes. If you want to, you can go back to Connect 205, all right? You can go to recordings. All right, here it is, week 205. If you click on there and you go here, it's going to bring up, and you go to that link. If you that link that you email out or paste into eCollege, it will actually be the edited version, okay? And As soon as you pop it up, it'll see that that's the 32-minute one, so that's our edited version. But did you notice you have the option to view original? All right. If you go to view original, then you're able to make changes that way. So you always have your original, okay? Just FYI. Next, we can show you then how to bring it into eCollege. Again, right now we're in our Connect, and then we go to recordings. We see the recordings that we have. We've made it public. We've done some simple edits. And again, this link right here, once you're in the recordings, okay, this is the link that you need for eCollege or to email out to anybody, okay? This is the recording, all right? Difference is, if you go just to the meeting room, this is the meeting for people for a live meeting, okay? And then once you hit record within the meeting, it's going to bring you a new link, and it's going to generate a URL for those recordings, okay? It might sound a little confusing, but again, just remember that this is always what you use to have people come into live meeting, and then keep your recordings, your lectures, and they will record, and they'll have multiple ones here, and this is the link that you use to, you know, send out, be like, again, please check out this lecture, you can find it here at this link below. So all you do is highlight, copy, and paste to wherever it needs to go.